Welcome to the Green Building Show, where we investigate green design and building trends throughout Australia.
In this series of the Green Building Show, we've been looking at the renovator's delight. This week, we'll be looking at how to pick a house that's primed for renovation and how to steer clear of a dreaded money pit. So what are the key differences between a diamond in the rough and a lemon? First up, good bones. How do you pick them in a house?
Good bones implies that the general structure there is okay and you just need to do all the surface bits.
So a fresh paint job, new kitchen and bathroom, landscaping, the simple cosmetic changes. But are good bones enough?
It doesn't always work well because sometimes you've got houses that are back to front. So all the living areas are at the front and you've got the laundry and the backyard's blocked off. And so it might be built solidly and built well, but it's just all in the wrong place. So sometimes you've got to look further than just for good bones.
Moving internal walls can be a costly exercise. So what red flags should you look for in a house with seemingly good bones?
Rewiring is a common problem. Having to replace all your plumbing pipes from clay to PVC. Stormwater can be a big one. In the olden days, they didn't have a lot of the standard practices that we have now. So some of the foundations might just be rock on earth. They don't have proper concrete footings and things like that. So they don't really have flashings and damp-proof courses. And so all of those sorts of things can be a real problem.
If the basic services like electricity wiring, plumbing, roof and foundations of a house are not serviceable or need to be repaired, then you may have a lemon. These kind of services are expensive and time consuming to repair or replace. They won't have an immediate impact on the look of the property either, or its value. So what can the home buyer do to avoid making expensive mistakes?
Now you've heard of building advice and pest advice. Well, there's also pre-purchase development advice, and that's about telling people what the issues are with a property, what you can do, what you can't do, and also to some degree how much you'd expect to pay for that sort of those changes.
Adam says that he advises that 7 out of every 10 properties he inspects for pre-purchase advice are not bought. So spending on advice from an expert upfront could save you big money in the long run. 35% of homes sold have some type of termite damage, timber fungus, or dry rot. Building Inspector Jerry Tyrrell from Tyrrell's Property Inspections says as a rule of thumb, neglect-based replacement and repairs start in properties that are around 30 years old. Serious liabilities start after 50 years. He also recommends speaking to a building consultant or architect before you buy any home to work out if your renovation plans are feasible. So what should we be looking for in a property to renovate?
Ideally, it can do a little bit too, like give it a sand, a paint, a polish, a clean up the garden, all the easy stuff, the stuff that doesn't require tradesmen. And then that can increase the value quite a lot.
To avoid buying a money pit, make sure you research, research, research. Get a building inspection, pest inspection and pre-purchase advice. By working through these simple steps, you can avoid getting yourself into trouble. Next week on the Green Building Show, we'll be looking at the types of homes that are the easiest and most cost-effective to renovate.